For the first time in nearly nine decades, a sitting American president is in Cuba. President Obama's historic arrival in Havana ends decades of isolation. The president said this morning he will announce plans for Google to improve Cuba's internet access. The visit highlights big challenges on the communist island, including human rights concerns.
6 in 10 Americans in a new CBS News New York Times poll think that restoring diplomacy with Cuba is mostly good for the United States, and 40% say it will lead to more democracy in Cuba. Just 3% say less, 50% say it will make no difference at all. Margaret Brennan is in Havana with what the president hopes to accomplish there. Margaret, good morning.
Good morning. This is a direct appeal by President Obama to end a half century of tension. He'll press Cuban leader Raul Castro to make reforms and try to convince him that engagement is better than isolation.
This was a view from Air Force One as it glided onto the tarmac. Minutes later, President Barack Obama peeked out of the doorway, becoming the first U.S. sitting president to visit since Calvin Coolidge arrived 88 years ago. Trailed by the first family, Mr. Obama made history.
Back in 1928, President Coolidge came on a battleship. It took him 3 days to get here. It only took me 3 hours. For the first time ever, Air Force One has landed in Cuba.
Hundreds of Cubans braved the rain to watch the presidential motorcade whisk by. Many hung from windows and waved to the first family as they strolled through old Havana. But some things have not changed in this authoritarian state. Just hours before Mr. Obama arrived, the Castro government arrested several dozen protesters. Improving human rights will be on the agenda during today's meeting with Cuban leader Raul Castro. And despite the ongoing trade embargo, they'll discuss what they can do to strengthen economic ties. Several major business leaders joined the president's delegation, including the CEO of Xerox and executives from companies like Marriott and Starwood, which just struck a deal to become the first American hotel operator in Havana in nearly 60 years.
Well, the administration hopes that deeper financial ties will breathe life into the struggling Cuban economy and lead to irreversible change. But everything is constrained by the Castro government's reluctance to make those much-needed reforms and that decades-long U.S. trade embargo.
Margaret Brennan in Havana. Thanks, Margaret.